हेलो एवरीवन। सो कल का वीडियो शायद आपको बहुत ज़्यादा मदद किया हो, राइट? और आज हम लोग आगे और भी पार्ट सी सेक्शन का कुछ क्वेश्चंस को डील करेंगे, ओके? सो आज हम लोग क्या करने वाले हैं, अगेन 4 से 5 क्वेश्चंस अगेन जो नेट में आ चुके हैं इन इसी मेथड, सो दैट कि आपको ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा फ़ायदा हो और आप उसमें और अच्छे से कॉन्फिडेंट हो पाए और नेट एग्ज़ाम आपको बहुत अच्छा जाए, राइट? वही इसका मकसद है। और लेट्स ट्राई टू डू आवर बेस्ट हियर, ओके? सो दैट यू फील कंफर्टेबल व्हाइल सॉल्विंग मैथमेटिक्स एंड बी हैप्पी व्हाइल डूइंग मैथमेटिक्स, ओके? सो डू मैथमेटिक्स एज मच एज यू कैन, ओके? सो हियर लेट्स सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन नंबर 65, बुकलेट कोड बी, ओके? सो अगेन आई एम डूइंग दिस, सो हियर लेट्स सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन पार्ट सी सेक्शन। S is any number between 0 and 1, then which of the following are going to be true? First option is, for all m belongs to natural number, their existence such that S is greater than m by n. For all m belongs to natural number, their existence belongs to natural number such that S is less than m by n. For all m belongs to natural number, their existence belongs to natural number such that S equal to m by n. Fourth, for all m belongs to natural number, their existence belongs to n such that S equal to m plus n. How are we solve this question? You know, this is very basic questions and this is like elementary question. I mean, if you ask this kind of question to 11, 12 standard boy, they can also give the answer. There is no logic behind it. So let's try to solve this question in easy way, right? So how do you think such kind of question, right? So first of all, what is given? So they are asking about some relation related to m by n, right? Look at the pattern. They are asking something related to m by n. What do you know about m by n? For all n, doesn't matter which m you will give me, m by n is always tends to 0 as n tends to infinity, right? Doesn't matter which m you will give me, m by n as long as n tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. So m by n can be made as small as we please after certain terms. N not is some fixed natural number, right? So let's come to the first option. What you are saying, for all n belongs to this, s is greater than m by n. Of course, so take epsilon equal to s. So m by n is less than s, for all n greater than equal to n naught. So doesn't matter, you give me one m, so that's going to work for all of your m. So m by n is less than n. Okay? So that's going to work. Okay? Done. Second option. What is the second option? For all n belongs to natural number, there exists n belongs to natural number such that s is less than m by n. Again. So let's partition this. 0 and 1 are not in my hand, but what I can do is, you give me any number in between 0 and 1. So there will be two chances. Either it should belong to here, it belongs to there, or it can be half. But doesn't matter. Any number from 0 to 1 is always implies s is less than 1 by 1. And 1 by 1 is always less than equal to m by 1. So that is s is less than m by n. For all m belongs to natural number and n is equal to 1. So if you take n equal to 1, there exists n, they are saying, right? There exists n. Of course there exists n. Take n equal to 1 and m you can pick any natural number. That's going to work, right? So that's the way to do. So simple ideas, right? And for all m belongs to n, natural there exists n such that s equal to m by n. Means you are forcing that any number between 0 and 1 can be ratio of two natural numbers. It's false. Take any irrational number from 0 to 1 and that irrational number, for example, root 1 by root 2. You cannot write as m by n because this is rational and this is irrational. So this is false. Again, any s you are saying is equal to m plus n. There are various ways. N plus n, natural number sum is always greater than or equal to 2, and of course your s is less than 1, so how it can be possible again? And second example, you can take 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2 is a irrational number and this is integer, so it's again not true. So do like this, think like this. Just look at the pattern and follow what is given, what I have to do in short time, and do that questions. Okay? So I hope you got it, right? So now let's come to this question number 66. Again, booklet could be. So what is the question? Consider this sequence of functions. Fnx is equal to minus x to the power n, where x belongs to 0 to 1. Then what you can say? There exists a pointwise convergence subsequence of fn. Number one, fn has no pointwise convergence subsequence. Third, fn converges pointwise everywhere in, of course, in 0 1. Everywhere means in 0 1, right? In 0 1. Okay. And fn has exactly one pointwise convergent subsequence. Again, you know, for to solve such kind of question, you should know what do you mean by sequence, subsequence, and all those things. And I hope you know. If you don't know, go back and learn those basic definitions about sequences and subsequences. Then you are able to answer such kind of questions. Okay? So again, let's come. So what is given? So how to think here? What is given first? Given is this. This. Then they are asking where x belongs to, of course, in 0 to 1. Then they are asking, there exists a pointwise convergence subsequence of fn. Of course, yes, pointwise convergence, see, minus x to the power n is given. So, you can make it positive by certain choices for n. And what are those choices? Tick even numbers. So, look for this, even subsequences. What is that? Minus x to the power 2n, and which is x to the power 2n, right? And these subsequences converges. These subsequences converges to a point 0 if x lies strictly less than 1 and equal to 1 if x equal to 1. So this sequence converges pointwise. So there exists a pointwise convergence subsequence, even sequences, even term sequences. Fn is no pointwise convergent subsequence. Fn is no pointwise convergent subsequence. This is a negation of this, so this is wrong. Fn converges pointwise everywhere. Let's see. Does it imply fn converges pointwise everywhere? Where is the problem? You know, problem is only at x equal to 1. If I put x equal to 1, what is going to happen? Fn of 1 is nothing but minus 1 to the power n. And we know that this sequence does not converge, it diverges. So again, fn converges pointwise everywhere is fault. Not everywhere. At x equal to 1, I have to remember. This sequence does not converge. False. Fn is exactly one pointwise convergent subsequence. Again, false. You know, take the odd sequences. Fn plus x minus this. What is this? Minus x to the power. Fn has exactly one pointwise convergent sequence. No, take even. Even one. You know, minus x to the power 2n, that's nothing but x of 2n. And look at this. You know, this sequence. If you have a sequence which converges, then how many subsequences it has? A sequence has infinitely many subsequences. And if a sequence is converges, then all its subsequences also converge. So of course, uniqueness is false. So this is, if this is sequence going to converge, take f of 4n, multiple of 4n, take multiple of 6n. These are all subsequences of f of 2n, and these are not same, right? So fn has exactly one pointwise convergent subsequence is false. Look at, these are all subsequences of f of 2n. So this is a subsequence of this, and this is a subsequence of fn. Hence, this is a subsequence of your original sequence, and they are all convergent because original that paired sequences converges. So this is what you do think, right? And be confident, okay? I hope you got it. Now, let's come to here, the question number 67. Which of the following is a true for the function fx equal to sin x times sin 1 by x, x belongs to open 0, 1. Is this lower limit of fx, but the limit of fx is equal to same as lim sup? Limit is less than lim sup, limit is equal to 1, or lim sup is going to be 0. What is going to be true? That's what you have to answer, that's what they have asked. So, how one can think here, how one can answer such kind of questions, okay? That's what I'm going to do that. So, what is given? Given is here this, fx is equal to sin x times sin 1 by x. X belongs to 0 to 1. And they are asking about lim sup and limit. You know, if limit of a function at certain that point exists, if limit of a function at that point exist, then lim sup and lim imperfect, this is if and only if condition. Use that fact. Okay? So the fact is lim sup and lim imperfect when limit exists, right? So that's what I'm going to do that. Let us evaluate, try to evaluate what is the limiting value of this function, right? Limiting value x tends to 0. Sin x into sin 1 by x, right? See, this function oscillates near to 0 from minus 1 to plus 1, right? This function oscillates from, this is some crazy function near to minus, near 0. Doesn't matter, some finite number, minus 1 to 0, 1. But this function is continuous. So limiting value of sin x when x tends to 0 is of course 0. So 0 times any finite value is nothing but 0. And you can prove it by using epsilon delta definition also. So I don't care, for shortcuts you should go like this. So limiting value of this is 0. Therefore, limit of this function is equal to 0 is equal to lim sup of fx as x tends to 0. These are same, and hence lim sup and lim sup 0, lim imperfect. So 1 and 4 is the correct option and 2 and 3 are wrong options. Okay, so this is the way to do like this. Try to understand it. One line argument how we handle this. Okay, so be confident. Okay, I hope you got it. So now I'm going to do question number 68. Okay, and so far we have finished 60 question till question 67. So 68 part C question. Look at this question. What is the question? Question A is, consider n cross n matrix with all entries are from integer, and that matrix is such that AB is invertible. AB is equal to identity matrix. A is invertible matrix. So, and where B is, let's say that is Bij. Then what you can say? These are the fourth option, four options. First is, if determinant of A is 1, then determinant of B is going to be 1. Second, a sufficient condition for each Bij to be an integer is that determinant of A is an integer. Third, B is always an integer matrix. Fourth, a necessary condition for each Bij to be an integer is determinant of A is either 1 or minus 1. Right? So that's what I am going to do this. This is again very trivial question. I have uploaded a solution in earlier also. So you can do that. But again, in short time, how I can do such kind of questions? So solutions. How do you think here? This thing. So what is given? You have given me A is an integer matrix and A is invertible. Take a determinant both sides. So determinant of A times determinant of B equal to 1. If you give me, it's because this is integer, right? So this is integers times something is equal to 1, right? So determinant of B is equal to 1 by determinant of A. That's what I can know. Let's come to first option. Determinant of A is 1, that implies determinant of B is equal to 1. This is 1, that implies determinant of B is 1. Yes, done. This is correct. A sufficient condition for each Bij to be integer is that determinant of A is an integer. No. Sufficient condition for each Bij to be integer is that determinant of A is an integer. See, determinant of A is always integer. Isme ko do raha hai nahi. Determinant of A is always integer. Let's say determinant of A is 2. That does not imply determinant of B is integer. That time determinant of B is what? This is wrong. Determinant of B is what? 1 by 2 by previous one. So it's not sufficient. Like that determinant of A is an integer implies determinant of B is B, all entries in B are integers. No. If all entries in B are integers, then determinant of B is also integer. It's not true. False. So this is positive. Third, B is always an integer matrix. B is always an integer matrix. False. Take this third. Take this matrix 2, 0 and 0, 1. So what is B? B is nothing but inverse of this. What is the inverse? 1 by 2, 0. This is nothing but 1, 1 by 2. Look at this matrix. So now this is going to be 1 by 2 and then 1. Look at this. So multiply AB, you will get identity matrix. So B column is split by this. So B is always an integer matrix, is false. There are various ways to construct. Okay. A necessary condition for each Bij to be an integer is that determinant of A equal to plus minus 1. So, you know, for that, just tell me one theory regarding this. So, theory is here this. B is nothing but A inverse. So, B is nothing but A inverse, and A inverse is adjoint of A by determinant of A. Right? So, of course, if determinant of A is so, and we know that determinant of B is equal to 1 by determinant of A. So, if B is integer matrix, B is integer matrix, that implies determinant of B is integer. And what is the reciprocal of some integer is integer? This is integer means this is going to be integer, and this is possible if and only if determinant of A is equal to plus minus 1. Right? So determinant of A should be plus minus 1, then determinant of B is integer. And if determinant of A is going to be plus minus 1, then of course B is going to be your integer matrix. So this is the necessary. And of course this is sufficient condition. Okay? So you can do that, and this is the view. This video I have already uploaded in proper way, but if you answer the next portion, it's not more than 5 seconds. Okay? So do like this. Okay? I hope you got it, right? So we have done 4 questions now. Again, the next 4 questions tomorrow I'm going to upload. So wait for that. So what you can do is just try those more 4 questions also and learn from them. Where you feel difficulty, analyze yourself. Or jab main kal upload karunga videos, tab aap usse aap check kar lena. And jitna mehnat ho sakta utna mehnat aap kare. Apne aap pe bharosa rakhe. बहुत ही अच्छा होगा. अपने आप पे भरोसा नहीं रखेंगे कुछ नहीं हो पाएगा. कोई भी कितना भी मदद करे, जब तक आप खुद अपना मदद नहीं करेंगे कुछ नहीं हो सकता. सो बिलीव ऑन योरसेल्फ. आई नो योर बेसिक्स आर नॉट गुड एंड दिस दैट. आई नो देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम, बट देर इज ओनली वे टू सॉल्व दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. जस्ट स्टार्ट डूइंग मैथमेटिक्स एंड यू फीलिंग डिफिकल्टी, कम टू मी, आई एम रेडी टू गाइड यू. सो फॉर दो स्टूडेंट जिसका बेसिक बहुत अच्छा नहीं है, आई एम गोइंग टू हेल्प. आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू बैच फॉर नेट दिसंबर from 3rd June. So all of you are welcome for NET, GATE and BHM. Okay, who is also inspired for GATE mathematics, you should come and enjoy mathematics from 3rd June. Till then, do whatever question I have done, revise all those things and enjoy while doing mathematics. Okay, thank you for that.